Great night, very comfortable. The temperature was absolutely perfect, but the locals were loud, partying on a Saturday night. Come here, sweetie.
These tents are super easy to set up. Unfortunately, not quite that easy. Hey, sweetheart. Good girl.
Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel, Old Southern Pine. So today, Fiona and I have hiked back into the Minnesota State Forest, and we're quite a ways in. So as we get closer to Memorial Day, which is going to actually be next weekend, at the time this is being filmed, the woods are getting more and more filled up with everybody wanting to go camping. And that deters a lot of people. I particularly do not like to be around other people when I'm camping, so part of the reason that we wanted to do this was because we had found a really great pine thicket way back in the forest. We found it on just Google Maps, just looking through the state forest, and Fiona's chasing mosquitoes, which are just absolutely relentless right now. So, we wanted to be able to get away from the crowds and go find a spot that we could just kind of be out and hang out together and do the kind of camping that we love to do. So we won't be having a fire tonight because there's probably 2.5-3 inches of just super dry pine duff. You know, a single spark could set that up, and that's, it's literally the entire forest floor is just covered with it right now. And there's really, really great dappled light through here because there's a lot of overhanging canopy. So we won't be having a fire, but we do have a great meal planned tonight that we don't require cooking for. We're going to be making salmon aioli wraps, which are going to be really good. I've done those once before on a hiking trip. We're supposed to be getting great weather tonight. I think it's in probably in the mid 70s right now. It's going to get down into the high 40s, low 50s Fahrenheit tonight. So perfect weather. We've got the backpacking IMIA San Gabriel tent, which I love this tent. It just, it goes up super, super easy. We've got our 4-inch Zubaleaves sleeping bag and a Zubaleaves top quilt on there. The top quilt's usually what I use for hammock camping. It's real lightweight and packs down about the size of a softball. And then the ground is actually so soft that we don't need our Z-fold sleeping pad. So we're going to leave that bound up, and we're actually probably just going to use that as a pillow tonight. So stick around, and we'll be back here shortly for supper. No. No. Baby, come on out of there. Come here, Fiona, here. Come here, come on. Come on, turn around. Turn around, there you go. Fiona, here you go, baby. You want that? Here you go, baby, for you. Fiona, here. Fiona, you want this? Fiona, come on out, honey. All right, guys, we are going to sit back. We're going to enjoy the salmon aioli wraps. We're going to watch the sunset that's going on right here behind me. So as soon as I turn the camera off, I'm going to turn around so that I can enjoy that. And I can tell you, these smell great. I'm really looking forward to them. So I'm going to enjoy this, and I will catch up with you guys after supper. All right, guys, well, dinner was absolutely amazing. It was really good. It's always a fun and fast way to have a camp dinner out where you don't really have fire, or you can't have fire. But so anyways, we had a beautiful sunset. We're going to be getting into the tent here in just a few minutes. There's still a little bit of light out, but underneath this canopy, this pine canopy, that we are just, it's dark here. So camera makes it look a little bit lighter than what it is, plus the mosquitoes are getting real bad out. So we're gonna go in and get inside of the tent and have a little bit of a SWAT fest for those mosquitoes that follow us in, and watch a movie on my phone and have a good night, and we'll catch up with you guys in the morning. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, but as we're curled up in here in the tent, I can hear a whippoorwill off in the distance, which is relatively rare from what I understand here in Minnesota, but it's a common, very common bird down in Georgia where I'm from. And I absolutely love the sound of the whippoorwill. It's super identifiable because he always says his own name. Good morning, y'all. We had an okay night of sleep. We slept great, super comfortable, but it was a very loud night. We had a whippoorwill that was going off literally right outside of the tent all night long, as well as I guess something spooked some loons, because they had a good time carrying on and telling something how they felt about the situation for quite some time. So, and as well as a couple of other critter type sounds that I didn't recognize, different calls and stuff like that. But as soon as the sun came up this morning, the turkeys were at it, making all kinds of noise. So great night, very comfortable. The temperature was absolutely perfect, but the locals were loud, partying on a Saturday night. So we are going to, we're going to rest here for a few more minutes, wake ourselves up a little bit more, and we'll catch up with you guys for breakfast and coffee. good morning. We are going to enjoy this wonderful coffee, some oatmeal. You got the birds chirping. We're going to take the morning easy, and we'll catch up with you guys for teardown. Thank you.
right, guys, we got everything packed up, and I don't always show you guys the process, the pack-up process, just because for me, literally, I'm rolling everything up into a ball, and I'm going to deal with it when I get home. We've had a great time. I really appreciate you guys joining us. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do. And off she goes. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do. Give it a like, comment. I'd love to hear what you guys think, good, bad, or otherwise. I really appreciate you guys tuning in. If you've made it this far, thank you. We're going to start packing out. And, you know, as always, it's really, really important that that you leave no trace. You know, save these areas for people that want to be able to do it. Nobody wants to come in and find your trash. Pick up, carry out what you brought in. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode as much as I did. Until we meet again under the old southern pine, stay safe. God bless.